Hi, I'm Warrior.
And I'm Jetbat.
And we happen to have a special guest today.
Really?
No.
We do?
No, we don't at all.
Oh, that sucks.
Okay, maybe we do.
Hey, guys. Hello. Greetings from London, England.
Listen to that British stallion. Who could that be?
Oh, it's not the man who runs the channel, the man behind the gameplay.
It is indeed. It is. It's Mumra, aka Stoya Miyabi.
And the cat is out of the bag.
Yep.
It is.
Okay, so we had the idea the other day, you know. It'd be cool. Like, I watch these Call of Duty videos where people are like, I'm going to show you every game from level 0 to 50. And I was like, we can do that because Marma kept all of his good footage from level 1 to 15. So that's what this series is going to be. Level 1 to 15, the road to 15.
Exactly. There really isn't a sort of cap in MGO despite level 22, which is, I think we can safely say that is in fact impossible if you're playing legitly, playing survival. I think that's possible.
Yeah, for the most
Pretty
part
much.
At the moment.
Yeah, for the most part. I mean, the highest legits are 19 and they lose it often, of course.
Yeah, of course. Obviously. So, yeah, what's the first game we got? Race MM?
Yeah. You guys forgot to mention that you are in this.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not in this one, am I?
I know I am, and I'm level 16.
I'm not sure. Was this like from Thursday night or something?
This
or
was
like
from
a Wednesday night?
This was from, I don't know.
Actually, Lady Viper, aka Bruce, he's in this as well.
Oh, yeah, I think I remember that. He joined us here and there.
So this is our like first. This is my first NA experience going on here.
Yeah.
This is your first match.
This was his first night. It wasn't his first match because he started out as level 1, but it is his first night. It's his first night. I remember that much.
Now, Mumra, you've mentioned a couple differences and discrepancies, or not discrepancies, but mainly differences between the players and the gameplay of EU and NA. Would you like to describe some of them? That was nice.
Well, I'm still undecided on my findings basically from that. So I'm still undecided. I'm still figuring it out, and I haven't come to any concrete conclusions yet. I mean, I've got a fair idea of what I think, but. You know, I'm not ready yet to cast any sweeping generalizations just yet.
Yeah. From what I hear, it's NA is pretty good at shooting, but EU is good at tactics and shooting. So it's a trade-off, I assume.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, that's more to do with player style, though.
Definitely.
If anything, you played with me for a couple of survivals, you can tell us that what do you think of what I bring to the table as an EU player?
Strategies.
It's wonderful.
I love it.
I bring a lot of strategy to our team, and that is just absolutely delightful. It's nice to have
structure. That's nice. I like that.
I like that shot. And of course, you know, there's a reset there.
Yeah. I hate that spawn right there, seriously.
Oh, yeah.
Boned.
I remember we've had
guy just crumbled. Oh, that was right there.
The enemy gets that spawn, and we're like, okay, time to spawn trap.
Yeah, that's all you have to do with that spawn. Just sit there, you know, in front of him. Just shoot in there.
Keep him warm. Yeah. I remember this night as well. Like, I recall, like, finding it difficult to get a team together because, you know.
Yeah.
I didn't want to. I know I could have, like, got on Facebook or something and announced to the world, hey, da, 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 but I knew what type of, like, I don't know, bring across. Oh, there's an auto aim fail.
Yeah.
But, you know, I don't know, I just had a feeling I just wanted to just chill out, and I had no idea how often I'd play it, this being the first survival evening and stuff, so...
Yeah.
I'm glad that you guys made it.
I enjoy playing with you, Mumra, seriously, it's fun,
too.
Fun stuff.
Definitely.
I apologize again as well, by the way, because, what viewers forget to notice is that it's not often that when you create a new character, you get to see level zero. You know, so right now these guys are doing, they're taking a big, dive GP wise and maybe levels wise. If I come above them,
yeah,
I'm a level 1 and 0. I'm a rookie plus.
Yeah.
So you remember back in the day when if you created a character, it would be like one level less than your main, things like that. This is a brand new character. So
I actually believe it started out as in the start, what it was is a new character was level 0, but then they said that alts were taking GP too much, so they made it what it is now. I think that's what happened.
Well, that's the thing. People were taking people were taking the piss. They were trolling. You know, they would have their mains that they were protecting, and then getting on wrecks or whatever.
Oh, there's me.
Brand new. Yeah, there you are.
Yeah. And Fatbear disconnect. Ah, oh, that sucks.
Oh, but shit. I think it's safe to say you splattered that gentleman's frontal cortex right over that ice wall. So they're probably gonna have to change that out.
Yeah.
Get a decorator in.
They just do want to clean
put
up
a nice painting over it.
Wait a minute. Why do you do that?
Very possible. A brain over it, you know. It's like, seems fitting.
It is pretty fitting. Is that me again? I think that's me. Yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely you. You're the giant robot guy in there. Did we have random as we were rolling with then?
We might have. I think I saw one. That or Bruce.
Because I don't know anybody in the NA server.
Yeah, I actually played with Access Denied on my team once, and it was apparently a girl gamer as a.
Oh, I was about. That was what you just answered my next question. Like, is that a clan or a player?
No, that was a player. Access Denied, and I remember I was like, all right, you're a squeaker. Are you like 12 or are you a woman? She said, I'm not a woman. I was like, no, there's definitely a rule for that. You know, it doesn't exist. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, rule 30. Thank you very much.
Rule 30, that's it.
Jeff Ed's very familiar with all these rules.
Yes, I am a troll from the internet. I live deep within the depths of the terrifying places of the internet. Because I'm an adolescent, and that is what I do.
So, keep in mind, guys, the point of, like, these videos aren't to, like, have the commentary of the best matches. It's to show pretty much the same thing as what Road to Commander would be. It's,
Well, not really. I mean, those guys that do Road, don't they do every single game, every single match?
Well, that's the vanilla
definitely not what I'm doing.
Yeah, the first one was by Excalizors. It was, every single
shout
match.
Shout out to Excal.
Yeah,
love Excal. His work.
He's good. He's really good. But originally it was every single game. But what Mumra did is he kept the good games. But
well, I just did what I normally do, which is like, okay, if for whatever reason I thought it was entertaining or enjoyable for whatever reason at the time, I then keep it.
That was gorgeous.
See, it's reasons like that.
Yeah, I think that guy's ear is just gone, Mike Tyson.
I think he's solved.
Just disappeared.
Yeah, dude, it's
Houdini.
Train of thought there, but yeah, my general rule is when I do videos, or when I keep videos, because I do kind of like record everything. If I would rewatch, it, and if I would rewatch a video, then it's worth keeping.
No, you're here.
Because I'll watch a video and think, do you know what?
Wow.
This is not. I don't like this. It's not entertaining. Whatever. And then I'll just delete it. It's gone forever. That's it.
So yeah.
That's my rule. If I would rewatch it again, I don't expect anyone else to.
Yeah, but keep in mind that for commentary, like, it's the same concept with videos overall. Because it is a difference. It's not like we're just taking the videos from commentary and putting a fancy new name on it. That's just what I'm trying to get across. It's something different. Keep people on the toes.
Yeah,
especially with the MGO community, where really it's a small community, it's growing smaller by the day, so it's becoming more and more tightly knit, and we're having less people contribute for videos and different kind of content. And now if we're offering a larger variety, it's definitely going to stand out, especially if we're trying something new like this.
Yeah.
It's interesting you say that, actually, because I'm thinking these days maybe not. I'm like hopeful like that, because I've noticed with 1.36, you know, we've been seeing more, let's say, noobs, shall we say, like newcomers. Well, I don't know. Have you noticed that? Like, more giving it a try.
Now that you mention it,
pre 1.0, so. That guy didn't even shoot.
I know.
I hate when that happens. Psychic bullets.
Yeah.
That's what they do to me all the time. It's freaking annoying. But pre 1.36, I always saw that there was a few noobs, a few new players. Yeah. Not many of them stuck, in honesty. But
of course. And why should they? They were just getting glitched on like the rest of us, you know.
Yeah.
So, yeah. But now I get the impression that people are giving it more of a go. You know. Yeah. I like that.
Through the glasses and stuff.
You see what? I don't know if you noticed, but I do like to use the R3 quite a bit as well.
Oh, I've noticed that in your videos. Yeah. I tried to use that. I can. I tried to. It always ends up backfiring on me.
Well, that's the thing. My problem has always been I've been a settings chameleon. So people say, hey, Mumra, what's your settings? And I honestly tell them all the time, I don't know. And that's obviously been a part of my problem, because I will change settings on the fly all the time when I'm unhappy, thinking, oh, okay, this is not the right settings. I need to make it more sensitive or less sensitive.
Yeah.
I've never found, I've been playing this game 2 years, I've never found a nice medium.
I believe that, though, you did mention you found the golden rule, as it is the most important number of all the settings.
The
change speed?
Oh, well, that's the thing. I've said that. I do think it's the most important, but I've been sort of like practicing sniping in NA. Mm-hmm. And, of course, you know, that change view has definitely got to be 10.
I'd hate to cut this conversation short.
Sign off time.
It's sign off time. This has been I guess it's a little bit more than a compilation between, He Who Dares us. A little bit more. But, something new. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Tell us, feedback, of course. Especially to Mumra, he's the one listening. Check out our channel, ParraIlax. All that jazz. Catch you next time. Later.
See you in a bit.
Please rate this video what you think it deserves. Sign up at hewhodares.com. Thanks for watching.